Hey, what's up, everybody, and welcome to another weekly edition of Southern Rounds. I'm your host, Kevin Mack. I am so excited for this round that we have planned for this evening. Got some of my old friends and some of my new friends here with us. It doesn't matter. All four talented artists and songwriters. This is just going to be, this is an exciting round, guys. Thank you so much for anyone who's new to Southern Rounds. I see we got some of our regulars here. I like saying that, our regulars, just like you're coming to the bar of Southern Rounds. We have our regulars, and then we have some newcomers. Listen, if you're new to Southern Rounds, let me explain to you what it is. Southern Rounds is a virtual songwriter show, and if you haven't been to a songwriter show, this is what we do. There's venues like the Bluebird Cafe, and there's venues like the Listening Room here in Nashville, Tennessee, where we get together with some of our friends and we sit on stools and we sing some songs we've written, songs that you might have heard on radio, some that you haven't, that just aren't hits yet. And it's just a very intimate way to show you how songs are created and how they're born. And we do this every Wednesday at 8 p.m., y'all. This is Southern Rounds. And listen, we got some talent here tonight. We got Wyatt Durrette. You guys know Wyatt. Wyatt, how you doing, buddy?
Doing great, man.
Wyatt's here. He's here with our boy Levi Lowrey. Levi, you here? What's up, man?
Doing well, man. You?
I'm doing good, dude. I'm doing great. We got Clare Bowen and Brandon Robert Young. Guys, welcome to Southern Rounds. This is your first time. How you doing?
Really good. Thank you for having us.
Man, we're doing great. Thanks so much.
Well, everybody just doing dandy, folks. So I think we're just going to go ahead and get started with this damn thing and get on with it and get playing some shows. So listen, this is how we're going to do it. First up, Clare. Clare, thank you so much for being here.
Oh, thanks for having me. This is really lovely. This is like the first time we've been out the house in eons.
Doesn't it feel weird, but yet it's just exhilarating just to get out of the house and drive. Actually, just to drive somewhere and have a destination to be. It's just like, wow, this is nice. I have to be here. So we're glad you are here. So Clare, for people watching, tell them a little bit about yourself. If people aren't familiar with you, I know I am. I know me and Wyatt and Levi, we are, and Brandon definitely is. But tell the people, you know, tell them a little bit about yourself, Clare.
My name's Clare Bowen. I'm from Australia. That's why I sound funny. I moved out to Nashville because I ended up on this television show called Nashville.
Yeah.
Playing a character named Scarlett O'Connor. So I've been here since 2012. From a very small town in Australia it's on the Minamara River. And I've met the love of my life here, Mr. Brandon Robert Young, and we love singing together and we love hanging out with our friends. So this is wild. It's been a very strange year and my introvert is I'm on stun right now.
We're gonna fix that, Clare. We are gonna fix that. Let me tell you something, honey.
Shake it off.
Shake the dust off. We are here to have a good time, laid back. Just let it rip and sing some songs. Like you said, we're familiar with you with Nashville. We know you're just a talented songwriter, you're a talented artist. Listening to you, you know, I've seen you on the show, but even sound check, just listening to you and Brandon playing, it's just people are in for a treat tonight. So, Clare, what's your first song up? What are you doing for us? Tell us about it. Can't wait. What is it? What are you doing for us, Clare? Come on.
This is a song that is going all the way back to the beginning, which is the very first song Brandon and I wrote together ever when we met, like, I don't know how many years ago. And I tried very hard not to fall in love with him, but it didn't. It didn't work. But you know, it's good. We got married, 2017.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, yeah. It's called Oh Hello.
Yeah, very first song.
Go for it. Flowers and paper planes, little things that fade away, tiny lessons learned in letting go. Soft and still the daffodil, the only flower with the will, lonely blossom pressing through the snow. A broken heart's no simple thing, the nights we close our eyes. Found me
stars have I missed? Blinded by a single wish, looking past what's right before my eyes. But now I see so easily the way that life is meant to be. Such beauty in a heartbeat and a smile.
Brand new days make their way for every small surprise. Oh, hello, the little things I didn't know. Oh, hello, oh, hello, high and low. I looked and then you found me on your own. Hello, oh hello, oh hello, oh hello.
I've been waiting.
Now I found you.
I can't let you go. I've been waiting.
Incredible. So that's the first song you guys ever wrote together?
Yeah, and I was sitting there thinking, I didn't really know what butterflies felt like because I'd never had them. I did not know that that's, I thought I had the stomach flu, and I'm thinking, I'm going to throw up on this gorgeous boy. And I literally ran away from him because I was in a headspace of, I do not need this right now. But it was supposed to be a solo song, and I rang him and I said, I think it has to be a duet. And I was like, I'm an adult. I can write with somebody without falling in love with them. This has never happened to me before. And yeah, the rest is... Yep.
Brandon, that must make you proud, brother. I think I fell in love with you because I felt like I had the stomach flu. That is that is real love, my man.
That is romance.
That ain't no butterfly. She's like, I just feel sick, and that means I love you.
Yeah, I'm
and look, I love
late
you so
bloomer.
Much. Oh, that's a beautiful song, man. I love sure. that line, Brandon, that you sang. When you started singing, it was how many wish? What was it? The stars that I missed, blinded by a single wish.
Yeah,
that was what a great line, dude. That song's filled
you.
With him. What a beautiful
thank
song.
You.
What a beautiful man. Song too to have too to say. This is the song we wrote together. This is the song you have that. You know, it's so.
Yeah.
You know, me and my wife have whiskey shots. That's what we fell in love over. You guys have a beautiful song.
I just love the fact that the first song you ever wrote is called "Hello."
Seriously.
Hello. Yeah.
Yeah. It's, yeah. And we're still playing it, man. It's crazy. We got to play it all over the country. We went out on the road with Sugarland for their last tour, and we got to play it all over the country, just exactly the way you heard it, just mm-hmm. the two of us and an acoustic guitar, and it was, it's really fun to have the first song that we ever wrote continue to live and breathe and be out there.
Well, it's a beautiful song, man, and I hope y'all continue to sing in it for the rest of your beautiful lives. It's a wonderful, man. Thank you for sharing it with us. People are loving it too, man. We got people watching all over the world, y'all. Mm-hmm. We got Orlando. Well, that's America, but we got Australia.
That's a part of,
we got
people. That's a part of the world too, Kevin.
It, I know it is, but you know what? Excuse my redneckedness. It's like we got people all over the world in Orlando, Florida.
They're from Ybor City, man. Ybor City.
Ybor City, y'all. But thank y'all so much for being here. And I love. Listen, you can register, put a comment in, make up a name. You can tip. All tips go to the artist performing tonight. So feel free if you love the song to tip them. And I would like to shout out. So far the best name I have seen, because you make up your own name. Someone is the McHottie Pants. That's my favorite, McHottie Pants.
I might be related to that one.
Is that okay? All right, all right.
Might be a cousin of Claire's.
Yeah,
down in that's Claire's cousin in Orlando. McHottie Pants.
Oh no, that'll be yours.
Yeah,
that's my cousin, or this is his cousin. Well, listen. All right, we're gonna keep on going, Claire. Thank you so much. That was beautiful.
Thank you,
Brandon. Even though you sang it with her, it's your turn, buddy. Come on, what are you giving us? And let's keep it going, Southern Rounds.
Well. It's crazy. I guess it, you know, in this crazy life of music and entertainment, you know, we all have our heroes, and we all have the people that we grew up listening to on vinyl records or cassette tapes or 8-tracks or whatever it may be. This next song is a song. It's actually the most recent release that Claire and I had the opportunity to put out. Put it out a couple months ago, and it's, I can't even believe the words are coming out of my mouth, but we got to write this song with my musical hero, Johnny Cash, and he had written a poem back in September of 1982, and he wrote a love letter to June Carter, and at the top of the letter it said, "To June with all my love, John." And the date, September 1982. And the poem was called A Little Patch of Grass. And the story is, it's a story of love and longing and someone who's rambling through a city, but they really have a craving to be out in the woods. You know, they give it all up. They give all the fancy dinners and the limousines and the high rises for just a little patch of grass with the person they love. And John Carter Cash asked us if we would put music to his father's words, and so we did, and we got the opportunity to put it out, record it at the Cash Cabin out in Hendersonville, Tennessee, and then it came out on Johnny Cash Forever Words about, I don't know, 2 months ago maybe.
I think so.
Still can't believe it, actually. Most surreal thing.
Hey,
but
wow.
That's this song. Written with Johnny Cash, John Carter Cash, Clare Bowen, and myself. It's called Little Patch of Grass.
A world of cold concrete and steel. Tinted window panes. I walk the streets among the clones with man-made program brains. The subway rumbled at my feet. The lonely, sick, and old. I said never, ever. Such as this behold. I met a bright-eyed beauty. Had she fallen from the sun? I smiled and she returned it. Then she crossed on green to run. I quickly made the other side and followed just behind. Haltingly I said to her, "Lady, please, if you don't mind." I saw it in your smile, in your eyes just as we passed. Like me, I think you would leave it all for a little patch of grass. I take you across that rippling stream we hear the shallow water laugh as hand in hand we made toward a little patch of grass. She looked around the city, then she looked me up and down. Are you for real? She asked me. I said yes, but not this town. We walked and talked of common things, then I don't even know your name. I said, what's the difference, dear, when our hearts cry for the same? I saw it in your smile, in your eyes, just as we passed. Like me, I think you'd leave it all for a little patch of grass. I take you across that rippling stream, we hear the shallow water laugh as hand in hand we make toward a little patch.
That's what I say when it's a great song. I need a cigarette.
That's good stuff, man.
That's some good stuff, man.
Yeah.
Thanks
you
so
can
much.
Tell, you can tell us some Johnny Cash lyrics, too, boy.
Like, oh, yeah.
Like, no one.
We didn't change it, man. It was just like he wrote it as a poem. There were a couple things that
wow,
we kind of.
Was a poem.
It was a poem, and we wrote it. Or we moved a couple sections around, you know, like four lines here, four lines there. We kind of move them around, but we didn't change what he said or how he said it. So it's just
but
about
yo, touche on that music too, man. When you started playing, I was like, there's a reason his son hollered at you to help put that together, because
yeah,
it's
right.
Like it fit the sentiment so well for his lyrics. Like I was so interested in hearing what Johnny had to say, and when you set the tone, and it's beautiful, man. Great job, both of
thank
you.
Thank you so much.
Beautiful singing it too, man. Hey, listen, Southern Rounds is all about building you up, buddy. We are gonna do nothing but make your head so big you can't walk out of that studio, because we have the greatest songwriters on Southern Rounds. So get ready. If you felt down coming here, you're gonna feel like Muhammad Ali leaving, because you guys are freaking awesome, and this is what a treat. Claire,
so
I gotta
much.
Tell you real quick.
Yeah.
I got a text from my point person Nina, and she got an email. So Claire Pear, does that ring a bell? Claire Pear,
that's my dad, probably.
That's your dad. Yeah, he said, "Hey Claire Pear, we would love to be there, Dad and Mom."
Oh, and, I miss the. Oh, dang, you make me cry. I haven't seen them in a year.
Yeah. Well, there you go, Claire Pear, and I'll let your dad call you that. But I had to.
That's okay.
Tell you that email. So that's from your uncle, but.
Mom and Dad, I love you. Thank you. And thank you, Nina, for passing that on. That's really sweet.
Thank you, Nina.
Thank you.
Well, guys, cool. We're going to keep on getting it with my boy, Mr. Wyatt Durrette. Wyatt, what's up, brother?
What do it do?
What do it do? What you doing, buddy? I miss you, man.
I know, man. This feels good. It just feels good to hear songs and see friends and hear songs and be moved, you know? It just feels
yeah,
good.
Absolutely.
Glad to be here, man.
Well, we're glad you're here. What are you going to do for us? Guys, Wyatt Durrette, if you're new here, Wyatt Durrette's one of the biggest songwriters in Nashville, Tennessee. Were we on 15, 16 number ones? Is it 16 now or 15? Or are you counting anymore? Zach, he had a run with Zac Brown Band, Luke Combs. Songs with his band Yesterday's Wine with Levi Lowrey, songs that you guys have never heard that are just masterpieces. Proud to call him a friend, Mr. Wyatt Durrette. What are you gonna do for us, bud?
Hey y'all, I'm gonna play play one I wrote with you, K-Mac, and with Levi. It's weird where songs come from sometimes. Like I started this song, I was down in the Bahamas, and like I had just gotten there, and the air was just right, the sun was setting just right, the bartender was pouring them just right. Songs were just right, all those things, and so I had this thing come out, like I had a verse melody or whatever, and myself and Levi and Kevin Mack and Patrick Davis we had just finished writing another song, and I was literally walking out of the room, and Kevin starts playing this lick, and I turned around like surprised. I was like, "What is that?" He's like, "Well, I didn't take it. I didn't steal it." I was like, "No, I didn't mean that. Like, what is it? Like, it sounds exactly like something I wrote like 2 months ago, like the melody." And I said, "Just keep playing it." And he started playing it. And it's crazy, man. Songs come out of the stars sometimes. And this one
that was like something out of a movie, bro. Because you were like standing at the door and we just looked at each other and just started singing. And it was like, "What is happening?"
Yeah, it was one of those, you know. But I'm really proud of this one. It's I got a feeling you might hear it somewhere soon, but we'll see. Sun dipping down neath them cotton candy clouds as it's dancing around on the water. Soft southern breeze covers me like a blanket as the bartender brings me another. It's going down easy tonight. Man, he's mixing me up just right. Between this drink in my hand and a seed in the sand, it's going down easy tonight. She's cutting. You do it.
Yeah.
Take that verse.
Cutting her eyes caught me by surprise. Now I'm falling for her from a distance. Love is usually hard. Sometimes the stars line up just right. Then it isn't.
He's going down easy tonight. Ain't it good when it all feels right? I think that smile on her lips might lead to a kiss. It's going down easy tonight. Moon keeps rising. My tab keeps on climbing, climbing. And tomorrow's creeping close, but I don't mind it. I don't mind it. It's going down easy tonight. Ain't it good when it all feels right? I think this drink in my hand, seed in the sand, is going down easy tonight. I think that smile on her lips might lead to a kiss. It's going down easy tonight.
Durrette, y'all. Woo,
yeah,
house.
Man.
Come on.
You guys, so good.
That's so good.
Thank you, man.
Man, Wyatt, I love your voice too, man. Like, you're a great songwriter, but dude, like that song, you sing that song so well. Like, crush it. So
I appreciate it, man.
Yeah. Man, I was saying to Wyatt, we were passing in the hallway over here, and we had done a week down at Wyatt's house.
Gosh,
man, it was
a minute ago. I don't know,
that was so much fun, man. So much fun.
It was such a lovely time.
And we wrote, I don't know, we wrote how many songs we wrote in that week. We wrote a lot of songs in that week.
We did.
And
like five.
Yeah.
Like five,
and
six,
I remember just saying at some point, like, dude, you got to do a record, man. You got to put a band together or something, man. You got to do a record because your voice is so stinking cool. Mm-hmm. And
yeah, it is.
I appreciate
my wish
it,
came
man.
True. My wish came true.
Well, Levi makes me sound fucking a lot better, that's for sure. But
Oh, you guys are great together.
No.
Yeah. Oh, man, it's so good, dude. That's Wyatt Durrette, y'all. Man. One of the biggest songwriters in Nashville, one of the greatest guys, and might be one of the best artists, I think so, too, man. So great job. That was Easy Tonight, Wyatt Durrette. And he's sitting next to his duo partner. He's in a band called Yesterday's Wine. And he's sitting next to his duo partner, Mr. Levi Lowrey. Levi has written songs like Colder Weather for Zac Brown, The Wind. I remember seeing Levi for the first time I saw him. I was in Virginia Beach at the Virginia Beach Amphitheater, and he was opening for Zac. And I just him and his guitar, like, in front of 25,000 people. And I was like, I love this guy. He's awesome. and he became a homie, and he's a talent, man. He's one of our modern day. He's one of the greatest poets in our generation, Mr. Levi Lowrey. What you doing, bud?
Man. Yeah, man.
Hey, I love you, man. I appreciate you saying that.
I love you, too. I love you more.
I also wanted to tell you, I figured this is probably an appropriate time. I'm sorry I didn't call you back.
What? You never do, man.
And I'm sorry about that.
Don't tell me sorry.
I'll
get a text.
Hey, you want to write next week?
But you can't call me back when you call.
Right?
Just calling you to see how you're doing, man. See if you got the new PS5 or something. And don't.
No.
Nobody's got
yet.
That.
Not yet.
Right?
No one's got it.
No. There's a warehouse somewhere.
With all of them?
With all of them.
It's all right, buddy.
But yeah, I just wanted you to know that I love you. Please don't take it personally. I'm just a...
If I wasn't hosting Southern Rounds, you would never call me back.
No, man, it's not true.
I love anyway. You, man. It's okay. I'll talk to you soon.
He figured he'd talk to you now.
Yeah,
I'll talk to him tomorrow.
Yeah,
it's all good, buddy. What you playing for us, man?
It sounds like we should do another Yesterday's Wine song, I think. Since we were just talking about that. Let's do that Box of Darkness. We wrote this one in, where were we? Mexico?
Cabo.
Yeah. We were in Cabo and had an afternoon off, and we actually got together with Christian Bush from Sugar Land and wrote this song with him in the hotel room. He was working on building up some songs for his band Darkwater.
Right.
And this was supposed to be one of those songs, but we got done with it, and a couple days later we just basically called him and said, look, we like the song too much, so you can't have it anymore. So it became a Yesterday's Wine song, and he actually produced it. So,
and it was actually
he ended up getting paid,
right?
Anyway.
It was a poem he had written.
It was a poem that he had for years, apparently, that he had just never done anything with. And I think we wrote at least two songs that afternoon.
We wrote that song and Wait.
Yeah. Which he produced both of those on the Yesterday's Wine record.
But yeah, we literally called him. We're like, man, can we please have that?
Yeah.
Give this rusted heart away, but even thieves won't steal it. And outside the silver lining of this hotel, neon shining brings a different kind of dying that's keeping me away.
So grant me a little more time, strong wind to take me home again. Mama, hold me tight in the box I keep my darkness in. The lake is wide awake as the moon drops like a fish. The devil's in the give and take. He can take me just like this.
Dug a shallow grave. I've been Cain when I was Abel, and I have taken perfect love and left it on the table. For
all my sins and crimes. Redemption I'll never find. I'm asking just one time, will you forgive me?
Yeah, please grant me a little more time. A strong wind to take me home again. I'ma hold me tight in the box I keep my darkness in. The lake is wide awake as the moon drives like a fist. If the devil's in the give and take, he can take me just like this.
Please grant me a little more time, a strong wind to take me home again.
Mama, hold me tight in the box I keep my darkness in. The lake is wide awake as the moon drives like a fist. If the devil's in the give and take, he can take me just like this. And the give and take, he can take me just like this. Ooh. Ooh. Ooh.
WFLS, that's the latest from yesterday's
Blind. So
wow, good, guys. Love
man,
it. That's it's great.
Thank you.
Box I keep my darkness in. Holy cow, what a beautiful line.
You know, yeah, in the
that was all Christian, man. He had that line. We were like, oh shit, we need to write that.
Yeah.
Well, you sing it sweet.
He's a talented guy, isn't he?
Yeah, he's a good
man,
guy.
Man, he's prolific. Man, he really is. Like a machine.
I've never met
he's a machine.
A harder
he really is.
I've never met a harder working person.
And also, like, it's like there's the thing that's really cool about him is that it's there's people that work really hard, and then there's also people that really love what they do, so that's what makes them work hard. Like, and he's one of those guys, man. Like, he truly loves songs, loves crafting them, loves creating it. Like, that's the drive for him.
Yeah,
like that's the thing
just
that drives
genuinely
him.
Genuinely enjoys life.
Like
I've never really seen him upset or mad. It's really frustrating.
Well, you know, you gotta enjoy life if you're writing a song called Dark Box of Darkness in Cabo.
Like, he can do it, right?
You know, we were in Cabo and we wrote this song called Box of Darkness. That's where the songwriting comes out, folks, because the environment, they're like, this
it's all about balance, man. It's about balance.
But I'm sure zero drinks were had.
But Christian,
not a one.
But Christian is one of those people that can go there and not let it consume him.
Mm-hmm.
He comes out fine on the other end, you know.
Yeah,
because he's
song's
just solid.
Awesome.
Anyway,
so
I love Christian. We need to get him on here.
We will.
Oh,
and we'll get,
for sure.
We will. Yeah. And also, guys, that song Yesterday's Wine, they just put out their record last year. Check it out anywhere you can, like Levi likes to say, anywhere you steal music.
Yeah.
It is out there. Yeah. Check
it's
it out.
There. Anywhere you steal our music.
And we want to thank everyone, too. We got tons. Guys, we have so many people tipping us right now. It is crazy. Cheryl, we got Rifle
thank
Road
you.
Ranger. We got
thank
Nino. We got Doozers. What's up?
That's so nice.
No, it's Kevin Malloy. Rifle Road Ranger.
Yeah.
It's Kevin Malloy. Good guy.
That's right.
Yeah. And then, of course, my friend is watching The Outhouse. You know, they're a friend of mine. If they're
I love
The
Outhouse.
Outhouse, we love
outhouse.
You. Thank you for being here. Let's keep it. So, guys, that was round one. Ding, ding. Round two. I like to call this pick pass. So we're gonna pick pass it to Clare. Clare, it's your turn. What are you doing for us?
This is a song I've never sung in front of anyone before. Except for Brandon and Wyatt, who I wrote it with. This is an oldie, Wyatt. I hope you might remember it. I think we were in Brandon's little apartment. Maybe?
I'm trying to remember exactly. It may have been on the back porch of the house. that we live in now. I can't exactly remember.
He probably knows. It's on my first album. I really didn't write any of the, I don't know, relationship songs that people, I don't know, they said they expected that to come out of me. I wrote them, but they didn't materialize on the record. So this is one that didn't make the album, but I love, and we kind of just unearthed it the other day. And it's, I mean, everybody's been in this kind of place where they're in a relationship with somebody, and one of the worst things is when you're right next to somebody, but you feel so alone when you're just not connecting and it's done and no one's gonna, like, somebody's got to call it. And you know, whether you're getting treated badly or somebody, you know, would rather spend time with alcohol than you, it really sucks. That was my, like, thanks, dude.
That's a good song title, though. I'd rather spend time with alcohol than you. That's a good honky-tonk song. You should
remember. I mean, that is honky-tonk.
So I left the country, and everything worked out fine. But this is kind of like a battle cry leaving Australia. It's called Waiting on You to Love Me.
Well, I don't think I can hang around here any longer, 'cause my heart can't take the beating anymore. I was just a wide-eyed child when I met you. Now I'm stronger and I'm smarter than I ever was before. So I'm packing up my feelings, breaking free of all your demons, and I'm wondering now, what was I fighting for?
Sorry.
'Cause I've been waiting on you to love me. Look me in the eye and tell me there's nobody but me. I'm out of tears, I'm out of time, out of ways to justify why I keep waiting on you to love me, on you to love me. You feel 1,000 miles away, and I'm so lonely, even though you're only 13 steps across this kitchen floor. And I've been hanging on in vain, but to you, heartache's a game with changing rules, and I ain't playing anymore. You can tell your friends I'm cheating, whatever helps you sleep at night. Either way, I'm walking out that door, 'cause I've been waiting on you to love me. Look me in the eye and tell me there's nobody but me. I'm out of tears, I'm out of time, out of ways to justify why I keep waiting on you to love me, on you to love me. Well, I'm past mad, I wish you well. I hope you find somebody else. Look me in the eye and tell me there's nobody but me. I'm out of tears, I'm out of time, out of ways to justify why I keep waiting on you to love me. I've been waiting on you to love me. Look me in the eye and tell me there's nobody but me. I'm out of tears, I'm out of time, out of ways to justify why I keep waiting on you to love me, on you to love me, on you to love me. Well, I don't think I can hang around here any longer.
Come on now, come on. Man. Awesome job, guys. That was you, yeah, Brandon, cool. And Wyatt.
Yeah.
I really love that song, man. I really love that song.
I do, too. Thank you for that song.
You sing the shit out of it.
Thanks, bro.
I love finding, like, lines in songs that, like, Like you just stand out. It's like even though you're 13 steps across the kitchen floor.
That's so funny. Like, that's my favorite. That's my favorite too, line man. In that song.
That's my favorite line in that song.
You can just see it. You can see
it. We love kitchen floors. We love kitchen floors.
We do.
Oh, linoleum. Oh.
Guys, sorry. I love linoleum. Man, it's so good.
Say that five times fast.
I love. Okay. I can't do it once.
Whiskey fest.
Linoleum.
We say lino in Australia. You can get away with it that way.
Yeah.
Lino.
Claire, can I ask you a question?
No.
Okay.
No.
I won't. No.
Nope.
But you were singing. You have such a beautiful voice. Like seriously. Like,
oh, thanks,
such
man.
Such a beautiful voice. And like, so you were in the show Nashville,
mm-hmm.
and I was actually writing last week with Charles Esten, your buddy Charles. And Chip. I didn't ask him this, so I'm going to ask you this because I'm curious because you're both mm-hmm. actors. And so when you auditioned for that role, I'm sure they were like, hey, you got to sing for us too. Like, was the resume like you got to be able to act and sing? And then you just came in there with your acting chops and just like probably floored them when you started singing. I mean, because
thank you.
it's really, I mean, you're a great artist. Like, it's great. And some actors just can't sing and you can do both. You're
thanks,
lucky.
Man.
So I'm just curious, how did that happen when you were doing the show Nashville? Like your audition role for that, was it like, okay, here, sing us a Loretta Lynn song or do something? Like, what was it like?
I sang an Australian folk song, and okay. I was 2 hours late to the audition. It was my first pilot season in LA. So Nashville is the first American city I ever lived in, but I was kind of couch surfing in LA for a bit, and I was soaking wet because it rained in California, and when it rains in California, everybody forgets how to drive. And I stood at my agent's desk and finished the whole script because I loved it so much. And I asked if I could just go in for this character named Scarlett, which was I kind of fell in love with her. And I thought, what a lovely opportunity to get in front of these people, to, you know, somebody from, you know, I come from a very small town, like I said, and for them to want to see me, that's really lovely. Like, not everybody gets an audition. And I thought, this will be something that will help me with the next audition, because this is so good. This is going to go to somebody else who really, really deserves it. And they'll be more established than I am, because I really had just arrived. And I thought, I'll just have fun with it. So I walked in and they said, where are you from? And I said, oh, roundabout. And they said, you want to sing or you want to do the piece first, the sides, like the script thing? I said, oh, I'll do the sides first. So we did that first, and I walked in like this. It's kind of a question I get a lot, whether I stayed in. This is Scarlett. Well, Scarlett's voice is a little bit.
I know,
like
that's
that.
Hilarious. I love
she's
it.
She's kind of back there. and I'd never been to Mississippi, where she's from.
She's from Orlando.
From the deep, deep south, so it kind of worked out. And that's kind of what I told them. I lied. They said, we need you to come back tomorrow morning. And my life changed in about, I walked out and they were like, oh, thank you so much. And I was like, don't worry, see you later. And they were like, wait. Yeah. and my whole life changed in 35 hours or so. It was crazy. I was petrified. Wow. I'm still petrified. It's just, but you guys are fun.
Such a good show, man. And you're a wonderful vocalist and great songwriter. You deserve it all, man. It's great. Thank you so much, Claire, for being here on Southern Rounds. And again, thank you guys for tipping, man. They're blowing it up, y'all. They are just making it rain here Southern Rounds tonight.
Yeah. It's like a P. Diddy video up here.
It's like, that's what I'm saying, bro. It's like, yo.
Where's Nelly?
Like, yeah, I thought it says two chances. I thought it said two chains for a minute. I said, oh, okay. But hey, welcome to Southern Rounds, y'all. Next level stuff. I'm Kevin Mack, your host, every week at 8 p.m. Eastern, BeHerePresents.com. We are here every Wednesday, and this Wednesday we got a, like you said, you're watching the knockout lineup, man. So we're going to keep it going to Claire's boo, Brandon. So, Brandon, what are you doing for us, man?
You know, I want to do a song that that I recorded on my last record. I wrote it with Claire and with a dear, dear friend of ours named Justin Halpin, he's kind of our, he's one of our guys, you know, he's one of our go-to guys that we love to write with. And,
he's a good mate.
It's, you know, I guess it's a song about love conquering all. It's a song called Monuments to Men. And, I guess it would be appropriate, maybe the song's not necessarily about this, but it'd be appropriate speaking about monuments to men and speaking about heroes. I talked about Johnny Cash setting up the last song, but, Well, Johnny Cash is my musical hero. My real hero in life is my father. And he's listening right now in the mountains of North Georgia with my mom. And I want to say happy birthday, Dad.
Happy birthday.
And,
happy birthday.
You've always been my hero. You always will be, man. I love you to death. So this Monuments to Men. Get this thing out of my way. So.
You're right?
Yeah. Every stone along the Nile that failed to reach the sky, every garden built in Babylon, all just fade with time. And monuments to time have passed. Every now and then comes a love that's simply built to last. Silver and gold, granite and stone, then there's you. Stories of a wall built around the world, and brick by brick they fall at the feet of a girl. And monuments to men whose time ooh.
That is one of the most beautiful songs I've ever heard in my life.
Good Lord, man.
That's wild, baby.
What planet are you from?
Not this
that
one.
That is so good, bro. That's some John Lennon. Like, I felt like, what? Like,
way this, up there. Holy
that
shit.
That is, that caliber of that is incredible, man. That is beautiful. Great job.
Thanks so much. Thanks
and with
so
all
much.
Due respect, you also have a beautiful voice. <It's>
like, hey, man, you got a real pretty voice, son.
Yeah, right.
you got a real pretty voice.
But, God, so good, man. Thanks. Man, that was so good. Thank you for sharing that with us. And happy birthday to your dad, man. Like, what a blessing. We got everyone saying happy birthday to Brandon's dad. Everyone's saying, hey, and Richard said there's a Broadway musical in these two. No doubt, man. This is so... What a blessing. Thank you guys for blessing us with your talent here on Southern Rounds. And everyone, too, thank you so much for tipping, man. They're still making it rain like a Nelly video, y'all. It's just, we should do that song, but do it in a hip-hop music video kind of thing where we're just making it rain while you're singing that song.
Let's do it.
Our good inspiration. Idea. Yeah, it'd be like a Nelly video with making it rain with that song. But anyways, let me ADHD. Great job. Beautiful
thanks
job.
Thanks so much.
So good. And is it, and please excuse me, but is that song out? Is that on a record, you said?
Or is it not? It's on a record.
It is. Okay, so we're going
to go around somewhere on that internet
where people can steal
where
music.
Steal
so everyone
music? That's
and the webs.
Let's go steal. Well, I for once in my life, I'm going to steal that one cuz that is a I can't I'm going to listen to that.
Steal on. With
Southern Rounds. Let's steal on. All right. Thank you so much, Brandon. Wow, I'm just speechless. Okay, mm-hmm. Wyatt, your turn. I don't even know what to say. Wyatt, come on, buddy.
We're doing you and me.
Okay.
Oh, we've only done one.
Hey.
Hey.
I'm gonna do another. I'm gonna do another song that will be a yesterday's wine song, I think. Yeah. Here we go.
Let's do it.
One, two.
Don't need no diamonds, don't need no gold, don't need no riches, baby, just let me hold you. You're like a Sunday morning, sunrise in Mexico. Cooler than a Colorado wind blowing, couldn't ride into my soul. Your love takes me around the world and back. Can't put no price on that. Don't need no diamonds, don't need no gold, don't need no riches, baby, just let me hold ya. Don't need no riches, high on some hill. Money don't buy happy, and it never will, it never will. You got a heart the size of Texas, with $1 million smile. Your body like a Bentley wrecks me, baby. You drive me crazy, why? Don't need no diamonds, don't need no gold, don't need no riches, baby, just let me hold ya. Don't need no mansion, sitting high on some hill. Money don't buy happy, and it never will, it never will. I don't need no gold, don't need no riches, baby, just let me hold ya. Don't need no mansion, sitting high on some hill. Money don't buy happy, and it never will. I said, money don't buy happy, and it never will.
Boom.
Yeah, that was awesome.
Big old hit.
So good.
God,
that was just fun.
It is, dude.
It's shocking that those guys would write a hit.
I know,
so
right?
Weird.
Yeah. You guys act like you've been doing this for a while.
So out of character that hit songs would come out of them.
Who did you write that with?
Actually, I'm sorry. I didn't even mention it. I'm sorry. Yeah. Drew Parker is who I wrote it with.
And, did you really?
Yeah. And we were actually, we had written, it was the same kind of thing. Like we had written another song and I walked over to my house and said hello to my wife and like literally was walking back to the house, to the guest house, like to go write again. And that kind of came out, like just that idea came out or whatever. But
Wyatt, you talk in song, like you literally talk in song.
And you got them all backlogged in your head. You just come out with stuff at the kitchen table and everyone's like, how are you? You're brilliant. Stop it.
Yeah.
That's just, but don't stop it because it's wonderful.
You stop.
That's why. That's why it's like everyone comes to my house and we end up writing like 15 songs. It's like,
why does it keep happening?
Because that, I'm telling you, man, that place down at Wyatt's Isle, we call it Isle of Songs. It's a magical place, man. There's going to be some big old hits coming out of that place. It's a great place to write. And Wyatt, thank you for sharing that. And always thank you for opening your home to us songwriters to come write some songs.
But I do want to say, and I haven't, thank y'all. Thank you, Clare. Thank you, Brandon. Thank you for being here. Like, we really appreciate it. We really do. And it just it's doing my heart good to hear songs, man.
Oh, yeah.
Same here, brother.
See, guys, this is an exclusive group, Southern Rounds, and we'd like to welcome you to the family, Clare and Brandon. You're in. Welcome to the club.
Fantastic.
Welcome to the club, y'all. And we're going to keep on pick pass, y'all. My homie, Mr. Levi Lowrey, my bearded brother, who I love so much, who never calls me back, even though I call him just to see how he's doing. Just checking on his health, just seeing how he is, and he just don't. I know you look at that phone and just go, nope, and just hit him.
Nope.
That's not true. That's not
I know it's not. I know. What are you doing for us, buddy?
I don't call pretty much anybody back.
That's true. Kinda, that checks out.
Yeah. I got a new one here. I haven't played this one in a live setting yet, so I figured I'd try it out.
Come on.
Little boy walks in the living room and says, hey, Dad, can I watch too? An old-time Western is playing out the final scene. He sees a lady in a sundress looking sad, a man riding off in a silver hat. Dad, I don't understand, why'd he have to leave? You can't see it from here, wouldn't make any sense. There's too much to explain. There's so much that we miss. One day we'll see it all. And from beginning to end, everything will be clear. You just can't see it from here. That boy grows up with a tender heart, comes to his dad when it's broken apart. He always thought the first love would be the last. Why did she leave? Was it something I did? Is it gonna hurt forever like this? Son, there'll come a day this too shall pass. You can't see it from here, wouldn't make any sense. There's too much to explain. There's so much that we miss. One day we'll see it all. From beginning to end, everything will be clear. Just can't see it from here. So much we can't know. Sometimes the doubts will grow inside us like a cancer. But you are not alone. Everyone's got their own questions, but sometimes the answers, you can't see it from here. It wouldn't make any sense. There's too much to explain. There's too much that we miss. But one day we'll see it all. And from beginning to end, everything will be clear. Just can't see it from here. And one day we'll see it all. And from beginning to end, everything will be clear. Just can't see it from here.
Beautiful, man.
Great.
Oh,
gosh, that's gorgeous.
So
who'd you write that with?
Man, I have this guy that I've been listening to for years now. He's an incredible songwriter. He lives here in Nashville. His name's Andy Golahorn. And one of my all-time favorites, and I finally got to, actually my wife made it happen. She set up a Zoom write with him, so I got to write with him.
Wow.
That's what we came up with. So that's it all gorgeous. Started with my son, so pretty, my son walking into the living room. We were watching The Mandalorian. And he asked me, he's like, well, what's happening so far? I was like, dude, I can't explain it to you right now.
Silver hat.
You got to watch it from the very beginning. Yeah, the silver hat kind of, you know. Anyway.
Now you need to write a verse. Luke Skywalker comes in.
I've got
he
some
kills all the droids.
I've got some Star Wars stuff, man. Dude, I might do that next. I got a Star Wars
dude.
One. Yeah.
I know you do. I know you do, little baby Yoda over there.
Don't y'all you nerd dude. Out, dude. Cut it out.
You said, he kills all the droids.
And he kills right? all the droids. Make it pretty.
It's going to be in my head for a
while.
Literally.
He kills all the droids.
Why do you kill all the droids?
Because they're bad, man. Remember, pick up your phone, Levi, and I'll tell you all
no,
about it.
No, see, you're talking Clone Wars stuff now, man. You can't just say that all drones are bad. You can't.
Mm-hmm. Oh, I'm sorry. Sorry. I discriminated against the droids.
We'll talk about this later. We'll talk about this later.
I love you, my Star
love
Wars brother.
Love you
right.
too, man.
All right, Clare. Listen, ladies and gentlemen, this is Southern Rounds, just a bunch of friends getting together here in Nashville virtually and getting together and playing some songs that we've written for you guys. God bless you. Thank you so much for joining us. It's 8 p.m. Eastern. Every Wednesday we do this. It's BeHerePresents.com. And next week, CSAC, they are putting together here in Nashville, they're putting together some heavy hitters for us. And we're going to have another great Southern Rounds with some of the biggest songwriters here in Nashville, Tennessee. So please join us also next week. Guys, we're going to hit it with a – let's hit it one more round, man. What y'all say? Y'all got some more songs in you for the people watching here tonight?
Yeah.
Is that cool?
More songs?
All right, let's do it. Maybe. Clare, you're up. Thank you, everyone, too, for tipping.
Hey, can we reverse the order and let them end the night for us? Since
let's
new?
Do that. So mm-hmm. Let's do that. So let's do it.
So one each right now?
Yeah.
Let's okay. do this. Let's right. do Wyatt, Levi, and then Brandon and Clare, and we'll call okay. it a night.
Yeah.
Great. Is that cool? So Wyatt, cool. Levi, Brandon, and Clare.
That sounds great. Groovy. Yeah, let's do Leaving.
Oh, yeah. You were trying that, the new...
Yes.
Let's see if I know how to do
yeah.
it.
we'll I'm going to try this works. One, dude. Yeah. My buddy Luke can sing his butt off, so he sings a lot higher than I do. But this song... I want to give it to my buddy, Richard Blackstone, who's a co-founder of this thing, the Southern Rounds thing as well. And we've been working together for about 15 years, and this is his favorite song I've ever written, and it's one of mine too. And you know, I'm a big dad guy like Brandon is, man. My dad is my hero as well. And I can't talk about it. I just gotta sing about it. Let's go. Daddy, I'm afraid. Won't you stay a little while? Monsters that. I'm not fucking it up. Won't you stay a little while? What am I forgetting?
I'm not sure.
Hold on, let me just look up Luke Combs' number one song.
Jesus Christ, why am I forgetting that line?
Man, it wouldn't be a Nashville Songwriters Round if somebody didn't forget. I've already screwed up, so I mean.
It's not a real Writers Round if you don't forget the words to the song. It's Absolutely. A rule.
To your own damn song.
You've just made it real, it's fine.
So Wyatt, it is, Daddy, I'm afraid, won't you stay a little while, keep me safe, because there's monsters right outside. Daddy, please don't go.
Okay, got it, yeah. Okay. Fuck. Sorry.
When you write so many hits, y'all, when you write so many hits, sometimes you might forget the lyrics, but that's all right.
We should just have Kevin recite it.
Pick up your phone.
It would be beautiful.
Daddy, I'm afraid, won't you stay a little while, keep me safe, cause there's monsters right outside. Daddy, please don't go, I can't do this on my own. Why the hell?
I don't want to be alone.
Before he left, he grabbed my hand and said, just cause I'm leaving, it don't mean I won't be right by your side.
Gotcha.
If you need me, you can't see me in the middle of the night. Just close your eyes and say a prayer. It's okay, I know you're scared when I'm not here, but I'll always be right there. Even though I'm leaving, I ain't going nowhere.
Sorry, y'all.
That's so good.
Dad will be late, and Uncle Sam don't like to wait. He's got a big old plane that's gonna take us far away. I know I act tough, but there's a churning in my gut that I just can't call you up when things get rough. Before I left, he hugged my neck and said, just cause you're leaving, it don't mean I won't be right by your side. And if you need me and you can't see me in the middle of the night, just close your eyes and say a prayer. It's okay, I know you're scared when I'm not here, but I'll always be right there. Even though I'm leaving, I ain't going nowhere. On my own, the way that I could walk this road alone. Daddy, please don't go, I can't do this on my own. Did I buy that by alone? Before he left, he grabbed my hand and said, just cause I'm leaving, it don't mean I won't be right by your side. And if you need me and you can't see me in the middle of the night, just close your eyes and say a prayer. It's okay, I know you're scared when I'm not here, but I'll always be right there. Even though I'm leaving, I ain't going. Even though I'm leaving, I ain't going nowhere.
Come on now.
Yeah, man.
Wyatt Durrette, y'all.
Oh, I'm sorry about that, y'all, man.
No,
like,
dude.
I'll tell you, man.
It's just one of those. Here.
I heard you sniffle. That made me happy.
Sorry, I'm sorry. Yeah, probably right at a really good moment too. Yep. Thanks. Sorry.
No. Like that song. It's weird. Like I wasn't able to, because of how it made me feel. I didn't sing it. Like I like up until about probably roughly a year ago, right? Yeah. Like, but for like 2 years, I because of how it made me feel, like as a father and a son.
Sure.
We got ones like that. It just. They
you
just
know, and I just couldn't do it. So, yeah. Like, I don't know. I don't know the damn song. Well good, enough.
And we,
beautiful.
And we just yesterday worked that up in a new key too, and I think that that's what we should blame it on.
No, well, it's just, like it's me mind fucking myself, but yeah.
Well, just like Jay Pieper said, it's really cool to see the Jay Pieper said it's really cool to see the raw side of you guys. Nothing to apologize about, especially when you've had 15 plus number one hits. Well, dude, you're good, man. We hey, listen, Wyatt, we've heard it on radio too, buddy. And that song, you know, I talked to Wyatt about it before. It's like you said, man. As a you know, I heard when that song came out, I was just a son, and then I remember it went number one when we were in Cabo. And my son was born, and like you just said, like the when you're a son, but now you're a father, and it's like how it affected me when my son was born was a totally different emotion, you know. And it's just that's the beauty of songs, man. How and that, you know what I mean? It's like I wasn't both when it came out. Now, oh wow, it hit me twice, you know. It's the beautiful thing about songs, and that's what we do here, man. And I think her name is, please don't forgive me, Aliki. Alika?
Oh.
Alike. Okay. Alike. Yeah. All right. Y'all know her? Uh-huh. Or him? Her. Okay. Her. All right. Sorry.
Hey,
forgive my Orlando redneck ignorance, Alike. But
she's awesome.
Like, question, any chance we can rewatch this thing tomorrow once just isn't enough? And I want to let you know, unfortunately, no. But, there's a big old but. Unfortunately, no. But we will post snippets. We got a big old butt, and we're going to post this on snippets from this show. It's going to be – follow us on our socials, okay? It's at Social Rounds Live, okay? Alike, right?
Southern y'all? Rounds.
Southern Rounds Live.
Alike.
Hello, Alike.
Alike.
It's so nice.
Across the ocean.
I like you a lot. Where's across the ocean? Where they at?
I like a lot. I like it a lot.
I like it a lot.
All right,
like
this is
lot.
Terrible. We gotta stop.
Sorry. We
stop
love
it.
You.
Sing songs.
Levi Lowrey. Social media. Follow us. Southern Rounds Live.
10
Social
people just
rounds.
Left.
Okay. Squirrel.
We fell off the rails.
Squirrel.
So I'll stay with the I'll stay with the dad topic. I actually lost my dad in August. He died on his 57th birthday, just kind of out of nowhere, a very unexpected. And it took a long time, but I wanted to write something for him, but I didn't want it to be too dark, because I tend to go very dark in general. So I ended up sitting on this idea for a long time and got a good start to it, and then got together with Dave Kennedy, who is a Southern Rounds original. You guys will see him more and more, I'm sure, if you keep tuning in. But and he and I finished up this song, and this is from my dad.
Such a good one.
The apple looked up to the tree. Said, when you gonna let go of me? You've been hanging on for so long now. It's time for me to fall. It's time for me to fall. The tree looked down at the apple green. Said, falling sun ain't all it seems. It's a long way down and that ground is hard. Let me hold you for a while. Let me hold you for a while. 'Cause when the strong wind blows and the rain comes down, it's me who keeps you safe and sound. Let me plant one seed there in your heart. You can roll away, but don't roll far. Roll away, but don't roll far. The apple looked up to the tree so high. Said, I did not know I could not fly. Where am I supposed to go from here? There ain't no place left to fall. No place left to fall. The tree looked down at the apple red. and told the apple boy, just use your head. The way to grow up strong and tall is right there in your heart. It's right there in your heart. It's when the strong wind blows and the rain comes down, it's me who keeps you safe and sound. Let me plant one seed there in your heart. You can roll away, but don't roll far. Roll away, but don't roll far. Apple looked down at the tree, said, I ain't ready yet for you to leave. The tree looked up and said, can't you see? You got branches of your own, branches of your own. And when the strong wind blows and the rain comes down, it's me who keeps you safe and sound. I plant one seed there in your heart. You can roll away, but don't roll far. Roll away, but don't roll far. You can roll away, but don't roll far. Roll away, but don't roll far. The apple looked up to the tree, said, when you gonna let go of me?
Job,
shit.
Oh,
great
dude.
Job, man.
It's emotional napalm.
Yeah, come on, right? Man.
That's damn, a that's Levi awesome. Lowrey song if I ever heard one. Like, it's so
yeah, right?
Good,
immediately, yeah.
Jeez.
I just wish, thank I wish so I could much. See, I wish, I can't wait till we can get back together, y'all. I just can't, mm-hmm. Like, it's just,
yeah, man.
Too, I just man. Can't wait, man. Can't wait to see it. It was, what a great job. What a beautiful song. Levi,
so
thank
gorgeous.
You.
That's
I love,
gorgeous, man.
Apple looked up at the tree and said, when are you going to let go of me? Man.
And you know, it's like a funny thing that we all do as songwriters. Like, you hear a song and you're like, well, son of a bitch.
As soon as started,
like,
dude,
how,
as soon
did
as
I, how did I miss that? Like, how did I not, you know, like, the first line, when I heard that song, first line, I was like, fuck. Like, you know, like, oh, yeah. Like, oh,
it's so
it
good,
right
you're
there.
Mad. It's a good
it was
sign.
Right there. Exactly. Like, apple on a tree, damn you.
Why don't you that? It's like you hear that first line, you're like, why didn't I think of that?
Right, right.
It's so good, man. Great job to you and Dave Kenny. Like you said, Dave
thanks,
Kenny's,
man.
He's yeah. We got an OG crew. He's a member of the OG crew, Southern Rounds. We love you, Dave. Great job on that song.
He's phenomenal. Y'all so check his music out for
check
sure.
Check him out. He's dope. He's yeah. Dope. He's dope. Everyone's dope here on Southern Rounds. Brandon, this is our last round, man. What's the last song you're going to do for us, buddy? Thank
let's
you so
go.
Much for being here.
Well, thanks so much for having us. Shout out to our friends Mark and Carolyn Hagen in the UK.
Yeah, we love you guys.
We love you guys. I'm going to do something ill-advised as a songwriter. I'm going to do something that I never do. I'm going to do something I wrote 2 weeks ago. We have this room in our house that we can go and lock ourselves in and write songs, and that's kind of the way that I think we've found our way through this time of, you know, hiding out at home. And I tell you what, it would have been impossible to do without the love of my life. And so this song is for Clare.
Oh, no.
It's 2 weeks old. Hopefully I don't screw it up. It's called Honeydew.
They won't know if you do. It's fine.
Sugar, sugar, honey child, if you don't mind, I'd like to make you smile. Oh, gorgeous honeydew, why don't you slide on over a little closer, hold my hand. If you got time, I'd like to take you to the promised land, baby honeydew. Sugar, be my little spoonful of sugar. Honey, sweet like honey straight from the beehive. Candy apple, candy cane, you're making mountains move just saying my name. Oh, lovely honeydew.
Frankie Valli over there.
Right. I know, right?
Come on, dude. That is so, that is like timeless, man.
I was going to say that halfway through the song, I finally figured it out. I was like, oh, he just writes timeless songs. That's what he does.
That's it, dude. Dude, that sounds like, it sounded like an old Frankie Valli tune, mm-hmm. man. It's a Frankie Valli thing, you know? It was like good. That doo-wop yeah. little thing on it, man. It's, that is good. Spoonful of sugar and honey. Claire, she's like had a night where she's crying 1 minute, now she's blushing. And
I don't
laughing.
Know what you guys have just completely messed me up. I don't know what to do.
She's like, I need therapy after Southern Rounds. Hey.
Oh, boy.
Thank you so much, Brandon.
That was great.
Thanks for having us. We really appreciate being here.
Hey, man. Listen, this is your first but not your last. I told you, welcome to the Southern Rounds family, y'all. Y'all,
welcome
you're in
anytime.
Like Flynn. This is great, man. I'm having such aww. A ball. Guys, thank you all so much, too, for watching tonight and all the great comments and all the tips. Thank you so much. People, guys,
yeah,
they've just been commenting hearts and just beautiful, and they love it. And, you know, I want to – Michelle said, thanks for a great night. She said, was having a tough one. I cried and laughed. Just what I needed. I loved it. I was able to meet Claire in Clearwater, Florida when she was sick. Miss seeing them live. Thanks, all. You are welcome, Michelle. And
thank you, Michelle. We're
just so glad you're here. You know, listen, 2020 was a bitch. 2021 is going to be a lot better.
I promise you.
I think they always say, that just run. You know, we're heading to the light at the end of the tunnel. We're going to get there together. And Claire's going to close us out tonight for Southern Rounds. Claire, what are you going to do for us?
Oh, boy. This is a song that I started as an idea, as a song about Brandon, and we finished it with our friend Melissa Fuller, who is just an incredible songwriter. Her melodies are just like, she's liquid gold. I love that girl so much. Hi, Melissa, if you're out there. We've done it once before, and that's it, and we changed it since then, so that's I'll just try not to forget the words and cry or explode, or I don't know what to do with myself. Right, I'm gonna have to have a lay down after this. But thank you guys so much for having us. It's been amazing, and it really, like Wyatt was saying before, it does our hearts good to be out and singing. We really haven't done this. This is, I think we played the Opry last a year ago because Mum and Dad were in town and Australia was on fire.
Yeah,
And that's the last time we were on any kind of stage that wasn't in our house. So thank you so much. I needed this today.
Well, listen, even when the world gets dark, we're still going to let the music play through. So
yes, sir.
And we did not let that stop us. So let's just keep on singing till we get back on that Opry stage, which I think will be sooner than later. Ladies and gentlemen, Claire Bowen, come on.
Chances after the others I had a dance with out of this world and all the stars. Who would have thought I'd be where you are at just the right time in the same place? I spent my whole life turning up late. I know a lot of people don't love you all my life. You're my guiding light. You shine so bright. everything happens in the right season. And if I went back with what I know now, I'd save us the heartache, 'cause I know somehow. In all of that time, all of that space, better late than never, finding my forever. Guess a lot of people don't believe in fate, but I do. So I would have found you down to my bones. I was made to be the one, no matter what, I get to love you all my life. You're my guiding light, you shine so bright. I would have found you.
Beautiful job,
Claire.
Thank you so much. Listen, ladies and gentlemen, I'm Kevin Mack. This is Southern Rounds. This has been an incredible experience. I hope you all have enjoyed. Brandon, Claire, what'd you think? Did you have a good time tonight?
Oh, I want to keep going.
We'll be back tomorrow night. I hope you guys are cool.
We'll be back tomorrow. Same time. You can catch. I'll be at the Kroger aisle 5. You'll see me there singing next to the Cheez-Its. Guys, listen. That's the only place I sing right now, guys.
oh, no.
Jesus and Cheez-Its.
We should write that, Wyatt. Jesus and Cheez-Its. I need Jesus and Cheez-Its. Oh,
I steal that.
All right. Hell yeah.
I already know what's happening. Like, I know you guys are going to write
Claire
that.
Claire said, I'd steal that.
Oh, Claire said a line earlier, though, that I actually wrote it down. She's like, it's like liquid gold. And I was like, oh, that's a good line for a Bruno Mars song. I'm going to put that down right here. But, guys, thank you so much for joining us on Southern Rounds. We do this every Wednesday, like I said, at 8 p.m. Eastern. Claire, Brandon, again, it's been an honor having you on Southern Rounds. Wyatt and Levi, you guys are the OGs, too. I love you guys. I miss you so much.
Love you, man.
Guys, 8 p.m. Eastern every Wednesday, Southern Rounds here. Please follow us on Southern Rounds Live. We always post clips from our shows. So, you know, again, you can check it out. Like, we'll have highlights from tonight's show on all of our socials. Oh, my God. McHottie Pants just tipped. Thank you, McHottie Pants. The only time you'll ever hear that on a show, McHottie Pants. Thank you so much. I'd like to thank McHottie Pants. Guys, next Wednesday, CSAC night. Oh, man. I'm sober. CSAC night, ladies and gentlemen. CSAC is a big company here, and they're going to bring some hit songwriters. So next Wednesday, CSAC. I'm Kevin Mack. I love you guys. Guys, I love y'all. Please be safe. Take care of each other. And we're all in this together. Love you so much. This is Southern Rounds. See you next week.
Cheers.
Love y'all.
Cheers.
Bye.
Sun rising on a brand new day. Peeking through the blinds where you used to lay. I can still feel you in the bed, laying next to me. Took a shower, turned the radio on. Wouldn't you know it was your favorite song? I was singing every word out loud like you used to do to me. Adeline, come on back. As far as I can see, you never left. Everywhere I turn, everywhere I look, I can feel you all around, so you might as well come on back, Adeline. Come on back, Adeline.
been the crazy kind, but I swear I saw your face.